How's it going, everybody? Matt Lowe here.
I don't know what that was. What if I started my videos out like that every single time? Would less people watch it than they already don't watch it? I don't know. If a tree falls in the woods, would you hear a queef? I don't know if that is how the saying goes. Moving on. You guys know the last few episodes have been about a funeral, and I tried to chop it up into small pieces so that you don't get bored. Me filming that, I know it might be kind of weird to some people, but I told you guys from the beginning, I'm gonna be fully transparent. I'm gonna show you what I'm going through, what I'm doing, and sometimes I'm just gonna show you random shit. Whatever, it's my life. You don't like it? There's a f***ing door. There's a door. That's my bathroom, that's my closet, so I don't know if you wanna go in there, especially because I just took a deuce in that one. Or wait, no, I didn't shit in my closet.
All right.
Let's get back to the serious stuff here, okay? The funeral, it was very sad. It was very tough to be there. But one thing I noticed while sitting in the viewing, I saw a lot of people that I didn't even know. I didn't know they existed. And a bunch of people that I used to know as a kid, and now they're all grown up, and I feel extra old. But my family, if you know anything about Filipino families, they are huge. 20 billion aunts and uncles, and then times that by infinity when it comes to cousins. So there were a lot of people that I've never met before, and this got me excited. This made me happy. This was something so positive, surrounded by the darkness of loss. Now, my aunt, she's gone, and there's nothing that we can do about that except for to respect her memory and to love the people that are still around. I did a bad job of doing that. I had a lot of trauma when I was a kid with this side of my family. This group that was there, a lot of them, they had nothing to do with that. And it made me realize that my mental health has kept me from making relationships with friends, family, and I wanna change that. Now that I'm working on things, I'm seeing things a little bit clearer, I want to reach out and get to know a lot of this family I didn't even know existed. And I think that's something positive to get out of this situation. So anybody who's watching, what you can take from this is the people that are still here right now on this earth. You might be fighting with somebody. You might not have reached out to somebody for a very long time. Do it. You know the saying, life is short. Life is short. And I hope that maybe you might watch this. And if you're going through a hard time, if you're fighting with somebody, whatever it is that might be happening, you might watch this and realize that that shit doesn't matter, man. Let's move past it. Let's make that connection and be happy with each other while we can. And I know that sounds kind of negative. You're like, oh God, you know, we're gonna die, but we are gonna die. Everybody's gonna die. It's just inevitable, but not everybody's gonna live. And I didn't make that up. It just came to my head. I remembered it, obviously, but it's true. Not everybody truly lives. And a lot of us, we do that by choice because of our mental health. And I'm telling you right now, these videos are proof that somebody who's not living a real life, who's depressed, who's full of anxiety, who's holding himself down, he can make that choice to change his life, because I'm f***ing doing it right now. And that's why I'm so excited. And I want to go full throttle into everything now. And you guys are gonna see a Matt Lowe 2.0 for real. And I really hope that anybody watching this gets pumped and wants to join me. And if you haven't, you can start any time. You can admit to yourself that you need to change, and you can start taking those steps. Whatever journey you're on, like I said, I'm right here. Much love, everybody.